How can I avoid losing my business email account? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Let's dive right into this very important question. I just read a story of how a lawyer sued Microsoft because his email account had become inactive for 2 or 3 weeks. He had tried for days and tens of hours on hold, trying to get the matter resolved. He used the email to communicate with his clients, opposing counsel, and the courts. It was a real problem because he had no way to know who or when someone was communicating with him. Is there some technical solution that I can put into place ahead of time so that if this were to happen to me, I could still get my email while the original email account was made active again? The short answer is absolutely yes, there is something, and you're very right about doing this ahead of time. These are the kinds of problems that once they happen, they're extremely difficult to fix. But if you can prepare ahead of time, then absolutely there are some great things you can do that can make this less of a catastrophe and more of an annoyance. Spoiler alert, this is exactly what I do. So there are two things we need to kind of sort of talk about. One is what I call disappearing email accounts. This is something that I hear about a lot on Ask Leo. It is probably the most common class of question that I get. People, for one reason or another, don't have the ability to sign into their own account. Maybe it's been hacked, maybe they've forgotten their password, and so forth. Again, the single most important thing to prevent this, of course, is to prepare ahead of time, and that means proper password hygiene, two-factor authentication, recovery information on your account, and so forth. Most importantly, though, I think that one of the mindset shifts that needs to happen is that when it comes to free email accounts, you need to assume from the beginning that the account can disappear without warning and without recourse. Again, that means you need to prepare. There's also another variation of this that is just as important to the scenario we're talking about here. It's not what you're describing, but it is something that falls into the same bucket, and I call that the disappearing email address. This is the scenario where, for whatever reason, you are using the email address that has been given to you by your ISP, or in some cases, by your school or by your workplace. But the bottom line is that you can leave your ISP or your place of work or your school, and that email address then could become invalid. It could stop working because it is no longer associated with you. A great example is that, yeah, I had an email address at Microsoft for many, many years. As soon as I left, it wasn't mine anymore. And anything that I had used it for, I could no longer access because I no longer had access to my old company email address. Again, this is about preparation. This is about making sure you are ready for these kinds of accidents, account loss, or changes, ISP changes, that would affect your ability to get your email. The solution is, very simply put, to own your own destiny. What do I mean by that? Well, it boils down to this. One, get your own domain. For example, I own askleo.com. Among others, but we'll use that as my example today. Number two, set up your email address on that domain, like I have, leo@askleo.com. Number three, and this is the counterintuitive one, set up a third-party email service to manage sending and receiving email for that address. This service can absolutely be free. And in fact, in my case, it is. I use a free Gmail account to manage all of my email on leo@askleo.com. It's all transparent. It's all email to and from leo@askleo.com, but I have this Gmail account set up such that it sends from and receives email sent to that email address on my domain. Number four, and this is, I don't want to say it's unrelated, but it is related. And that is, separately, back up your email yourself, offline, on your computer. The way I do that is I have on another machine a copy of Thunderbird that is running continuously, that is downloading my email as it arrives. If something happens to my account, for whatever reason, then I've got my backup copies. So, how is this all a safety net? In the scenario that you outlined, where your email provider, in your case, or in your the example you were describing, Outlook.com, a Microsoft email provider, or in my case, Gmail. If, for me, Gmail just stopped working, maybe I lose access to the account, maybe Gmail kicks me off, maybe there's something else that is a problem with the Gmail account that I use to manage my email, I return to step three, and I set up a different email account to now manage my email for leo@askleo.com. And what's neat about this is that could be another Gmail account, a different Gmail account, but it could also be from a completely different provider. It could be Outlook.com. It could be ProtonMail. It could be any number of other providers. Basically, what you are doing is changing how you access your email without changing your email address. Yep, there is a day or two, perhaps, of some confusion, some bounced mail, perhaps, some lost mail, perhaps. But it's a day or two as the changes settle into place. It is not weeks, as you were describing, of email that goes unreceived or unanswered. So that really is the single most important thing you can do, is get your own domain for your business or for whatever it is you're doing, set up your email on that domain, and then use some other third-party email service. Not all of them will let you do this, but the popular ones like Gmail, obviously, and Outlook.com and others will. Use those to actually send and receive your email. And then if something happens, you could just change it without changing your email address at all. Now, there is one final, I'll call it a pet peeve of mine, but I think it's important to understand. When it comes to your business email address, honestly, you should have had your own domain to begin with. Why? Because it shows a commitment to the professionalism of your business. When your business uses a Hotmail account or an Outlook.com account or still a Gmail account, what that says to the people you're exchanging email with is that, well, you're not quite as invested, you're not quite as committed to the business that they think you should be. It's not a reflection of your personal commitment to your business. It's simply one of many signs that impacts how your business is perceived by others. You can still use Outlook or Gmail to process your email, like I said. But by having your own domain and your email address is on your own domain, that shows a level of professionalism and a level of expertise that basically just adds more credibility to whatever it is you're doing. So if you haven't done that, even if you're not having a problem with your Gmails or your Outlooks, consider getting your own domain for your business anyway, if for no other reason than that one. I hope this helps clarify exactly what you need to do to prepare for the eventual loss of a free email account that you might be relying on. Like I said, this is what I do, and I strongly recommend, especially in a business context, that you do the same. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/159056. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.